Welcome back to a very basic space program. Last time we did our communications, well, our navigation system, it's going to be part of our communication system. We have a few more of those sorts of contracts. We may have a look at some other options in the near future, but for now we're going to do some other stuff. Today, we're going to have a look at this first docking mission. So please join me. Right, so last time we sent up our navigation system and one of its, well, its carrier rocket as such, had a docking port on it because I really want to complete this first docking mission. And it gives us a nice advance. It actually is about 1.2 million in total we get off it if we complete it. But we get an advance of 900,000, which I think is more than enough for us to start building our bigger rockets to send things to orbit Venus and Mars, which will then pay for themselves. Thank you very much, Jane. They will pay for themselves, potentially also getting some atmospheric probes because we've got that lunar heat shield coming in soon. And potentially maybe sending something out, because I think we probably have the ability to do it, something out to go to Vesta and Ceres. Now, we could have sent something out to Vesta and Ceres before now. Our Jupiter craft easily could go there. However, I would really like to potentially look at orbiting them. So we need to have a look at that. Now you can see here, when you actually go for orbit of things, let's have a look at the Mars one, for example. You need to orbit it and you need to have a periaps below a certain altitude. So it's going to be our periaps is important, our apoaps is not important. So that's going to be really important. Well, it is really important for us. It means that we can capture into as loose an orbit as possible around things. So that'll be good. Right, we're going to take the docking craft mission. That's going to pump some money into us. Now, we have already got the docking port. We've got everything like that set up. Now, that money is actually going to go into development of our next rocket because we're going to be wanting to take some parts. So we're going to take, let's find the right one. That is one. We want to take this. This is going to be our first stage engine we're going to start using because I just really like it. It's from the Proton. We're going to put a few of them on there. It's not got, let me just check. I don't know what its reliability is like. It's not bad if I don't remember. Yeah, it's a highly reliable engine. And the good thing is that once you get off the pad with it, if one of them goes, the rest have got good gimbal control, I think. Where's the gimbal on these? Where does it tell me my gimbal? There we are. We've got thrust. We've got vector range of 5 degrees. So that's not bad, particularly because we're probably going to use clusters of them. So if one of them goes, 5 degree is going to hopefully counter that. So we'll have that. There we go. And does that change any? I see. Now these get cheaper, so we might as well take this as well. We'll have that. And potentially, I'm going to take this. I'm not sure if we're going to use it. It's only going to cost us 9,000 to actually get it. And then we've got an upgrade for the RD 58 to 11D 33M. Now the RD 50 is, if I'm rightly, it's this one, isn't it? Yeah. So it's 11D 338, which let's have a look. That gives us 5 minutes of burn time as opposed to, is it the 50 or the 58? I need to go back and check. Is that the M? Yeah, it's the M variant. So it gives us, why is two of them showing? It gives us a good chunk of time available on them. Let's have a look. This one here has 25, 60, so it's a much chunkier sort of thing. We get 63 kilonewtons, and this one's taking it up to a bit more thrust, longer burn time, same number of ignitions, slightly less mass as well. So it's just a general improvement. So I think we may look at just unlock that. We'll check in the actual screen and see what its unlock costs and stuff are. So we've got a million left, which is, I think, more than enough to do some development work. We're currently researching this here. We'll actually tap on that so it's ready when we come back. The RL-10. We've also got this. Now, this is going to cost us a lot to unlock, but potentially this could be a really nice upper stage engine. Instead of using clusters of RL-10s, which is what I was thinking, this potentially could be really nice. So I'm going to have a think about that. We will start with the sort of standard Proton design with these parts. We'll see how it goes. But we may want to operate it a bit. So let me go away and let's go build something. But I think first we need to build that docking craft. So let me go and put something together for that docking, I think. Right, so here we are in the VAB, and yeah, you will notice this is the navigation satellite that we basically put up last episode. I'm going to use this as the basis for our docking program, I think. So we're going to take that off there. We're going to get rid of this tank to start with. So just this on its own would now mean we had 800 meters per second. That's not what I want. I want more than that. We're going to take that off there. I'm going to allow myself to take this up to have a, I don't know, maybe to have 500. Maybe 500 is good. So 500 kilograms, is that good? There we go, close that. And I'm actually going to give it a bit more battery because we are likely to be sitting around doing stuff. So we're going to apply that. There we go, close that. Right, next step. So what's our electricity looking like? If I shut down the avionics, what happens with that? Yeah, we've got more than enough for that. So we get about 11 hours without shutting avionics down, which should be more than enough to dock. Right, next step. I want to put in a new tank. We're going to put an integral tank in there. Let's pull this bit off the bottom there. I'm going to slide that into there, put that onto there. Right, now this, we're going to make it be the same diameter. I think that is the correct diameter, is it? Yes, 700. Wonderful. We're going to make this pressurized. We're going to put in some fuel. We need to take the engine off first because it gets a bit picky like this. In fact, we could just increase this tank, couldn't we? We have a tank set up already. Would probably be the sensible way of doing it. So yeah, let's get rid of that. Let's pull this up here. And then we're just going to increase this tank size. So we'll make it just a bit bigger. Whoa, that is a lot bigger. And I don't know how much it weighs. Yeah, that's a bit too much. So we're going to drop that down. We don't need a vast amount actually on this, but yeah, but it'd be interesting. We are going to be carrying quite a bit of mass. Where is our... Now, one of the things we need to make sure we do is not have things hidden in amongst. There we go. I need to take these off. Put those up there. Right. We'll take that back up to... I don't know, somewhere sort of okay. It says 700. Yeah, that's fine. There we go. Right. Well, what do we need for docking? First thing we need we need a docking port. I'm going to put that on the top. You see it's quite large, but that's fine. This thing doesn't mind. So there you go, docking port on the top. And that's all we need for that, I think. We could use some of these. I think I'm going to put two on the bottom just for roll control, just because I like a bit of roll control. In fact, no, you know what, we're gonna do this properly. We're actually going to use stuff that we've got. Let's have a look. Give me full control mass. I want something like, do we have, yeah, there we go. We're gonna go for lots of maneuverability on this craft. So I'm gonna put four of those there. I'm gonna put another four up here, just about there. There we go. So this thing is hopefully going to be highly maneuverable. That's what I'm hoping for anyway. We've got forward, backwards, we've got drifting left, right, all that sort of stuff, roll control. It's probably overkill. But we have a nice chunk of delta V there. Potentially we could make this lighter, and I think I'm probably going to do that. We've potentially gone a bit over the top. I think maybe that is enough. Maybe 1,000 would be good. Yeah, 1,000's good because we don't need to be dragging things around too much. And then we're going to pull this up just a smidgen, like so. There we go, just like that. No, I don't like that actually. I'm just going to pop it down like that. There we are, it's perfect. And that is it. It's pretty horrible actually looking. Now the question is, can we launch this? So let's grab a rocket and see. Right, so I have taken our Javelin craft that we used last time for our constellation. We've just taken the first two stages. We've put a more sensible fairing on. This is the standard Javelin 3 fairing. And we've just put our little docking target in the center there. You can see it's got a chunk of delta V in there. So even without that 1,000, we're looking at, you know, more than 1,000 extra to get into orbit. So we're going to be aiming for quite a high... We're going to try and basically... Yeah, we're going to try and rendezvous, but this is going to be an interesting one because the target vehicle we're trying to rendezvous with is going to be in a not circular orbit, and it's polar. So this could be a very interesting experience for me. So we're going to save that. We're going to build it. In actual fact, I'm going to build two of them. Right. That's going to build. It's going to take about 95 days. We have a Mars window, but I'm not sure I want to go for it, actually. I think, you know, we're not in a hurry for science right now. We're not killing for it. So I'm actually going to cancel the Mars window. That means this will be the next craft in. I also want to be building our next vehicle, our next launch vehicle. So let me bring that up so you can see roughly what that's going to look like. And we will probably put together some craft to maybe go to Saturn. We'll see what we can do with maybe a Saturn launch. Right, so I have put together this craft for you to see. We have basically three parts to this. We have the Discovery 11 at the top there. You've seen before. We developed that in the previous episode. We've got this stage here, which I'm calling the Low Density Transfer Stage A. It's the first version of it. And that's basically an evolution of our Hydrolux stage that we used for sending our craft out to Jupiter. And I've basically stuck two RL-10 engines on the back there. It's a much bigger, beefier thing. Fits quite nicely on top of this launch vehicle. What I will say is it's not at maximum capacity. We can actually increase this. We could increase this tank quite a bit in the middle to give it more delta V. We're actually limited by the burn time on the RL-10, and even with two of them, I am concerned that they will fail. So they will likely get upgraded as soon as possible. In an ideal world, I'd only have one of them, but with this sort of size and mass and stuff, we're looking at two on those. And then underneath it, we've basically got a proton. So we have the RD-0212 engine there, one of those. And then we've got down here, we've got the RD-0208. We've got four of those there. And then at the bottom, I believe we have six of the RD-253 engines, and so that's basically a proton just with a less interesting shape and a less Russian-y color scheme. The upgrade steps would be to take this top stage here and maybe turn it into Hydrolux. That would be my preferred next step with this, but it's a bit of a workhorse sort of craft. So if I just do the important thing, which is to change this so it's two parts, there we go, so it's covered, you can see that this thing is, it's expensive, primarily because of we've got a balloon tank here for our transfer stage, we've got some extra tankage, we've got some tooling that needs to be done. So if I actually, you can see it's going to take 1,000 days. If I actually go to what it's going to be like if it's tooled, our price drops by more than 50%. And time drops significantly. I think it's almost a quarter of the time. So that's going to be tooled, but it's going to cost us quite a lot. So tooling that is going to cost us $358,000, which is an awful lot. So we're going to do that. Purchase the tooling. Wonderful. And then I'm actually going to build a few of them. I'm going to build probably three. Now, this craft should have range out to and beyond what we're aiming at. We designed it that way. It should have the delta V to get out there, 8,500. So let's just check what can we actually do with it. Well, Saturn, that requires a 7,300. So we've got that. So we'll have at least one going there. We have Uranus. That's going to be, let's have a look. That requires 7,800. We can go there. And Neptune is going to require 8,350, which is within our range as well. So as long as we don't have too much burn off, we should be able to get to all three of those. So we're going to launch 1, 2, 3, 4, just in case, 5 and 6. Now we're not going to do flybys past one and onto the next because I don't think we have the correct windows for that, but those are going to be building. We've got our docking craft building. So if we look in our list here, we can see docking there is being built. We're actually going to pull up some of these discoveries, and I'll renumber them as well, so we'll actually know what numbers they are as they're being built. I'll go back and do that. And then we've basically got the that's it. We put that docking one at the bottom there. We don't need to put much into there at the moment. So there we go. We don't need that Javelin being built, actually. That is taking up build space that we don't need just now, the Janus. Because, of course, we're going to come and have a look at the Janus possibly in the next episode. What I really want for it, though, is we've got the life support now, so it can stay up for more than 24 hours or 48 hours. But we need a power supply. So we're going to be looking probably next episode at a Janus, probably with, hopefully, with some sort of fuel cell technology would be nice, because I think that's the way we're going to have to go with it. So let's get this docking target built up. I don't think this discovery here is not going to be ready in time for the Saturn window, which is annoying. We could put a bit of credits in, but I don't into improving this the build rate of the VAB. I don't think that's a good idea right now. So I'll pull up another Saturn window, which will probably be in about a year and a half's time, which is annoying. We'll also maybe pull up a Jupiter window and see if there's any of those that we can jump on. But definitely these two windows here we're going to be going for straight away. And I hope that we should be built by then. Yeah, I think we're going to be able to send at least one craft to each. So we may end up having to, you know, cut back on these craft. But we've got a lot of them on the queue now because we'd like to start sending them out whenever there is a window. And if we've got time and we've got the pad available, we'll start sending them out if we can. Right. So with that, let's go do this docking launch, I think. Right, you find us here on the launch pad, but actually this is not what we need to look at. We need to be looking up in the sky. So I need to find our target, which is here. So we're going to set as target. There we go. And we want this to be traveling north when we go underneath it. So about there, we're actually very close to it looking at that. That's good. So what I'm going to do is we're going to... You'll see I've got us the rendezvous planner up just because I want to keep in mind what the target orbit is. Ideally, we want to put ourselves in an orbit that's either similar to this or ideally probably lower than it for our periaps and about the same for our apoaps. And you can see the periaps of that orbit is there, so we can actually match those a little bit. Or we could just go for a generally lower orbit and work from there. So we'll see what's happening. So what I'm going to do is we're going to first of all, actually, before we do that, we'll check that we're not going to run out of electricity. Let's have a look. Oh, we might have, actually. We need to turn our pumps on so we get all of the juicy electricity into the craft. And we can't get that bottom one, but is it going to be needed? Let's have a look. No, it is not. Right. So, close that down. Right. What we're actually going to be doing is I want to fast forward time until we're pretty much coming up underneath this. So we're just going to fast forward just a smidgen. There we go. Right, and then we're going to align ourselves. And what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and actually pull ourselves into a polar orbit aligned with this. That would be our ideal situation there. We may not get it, but we'll try. We will try and get it. Right. And I want it to be as reasonably close, but enough time to actually turn. So you can see here, looking at this, we've got quite a distance there. We can keep going just a little bit more to about there. Oh, it's actually coming up underneath us. That's interesting. So if I take off now and we just go north, we'll actually slowly drift that way. But what I want to do is sort of, we want to come up like that and curve to meet because we are actually good. We've got a little bit of horizontal, like this way, north, no, sorry, east and west velocity. We're actually heading to the east a little bit. We want to cancel that out, but also use it to take us underneath the orbit of our target. So we're just going to go a little bit more, and there we go. That's it. I think that's going to be it. Yeah, I think I feel as though that's about right. So we'll start turning there. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to go with that. So here we are. The craft is ready. We're going to be aiming to start with. We're going to aim 90, and we're going to let it take us up there, and then we'll fire it back when we're ready. Get ourselves into the usual position. Got the lights only shining on the bottom half of the craft there. Right, everything is good. And I think we're ready to go, so let's hit those engines. We have a good light, and we're firing. And then we're going to start turning over very soon, about now. There we go. Give it a big push. And we're going to have that thrust really pushing us for quite a while. Those casters are really helping. Now, there is... an upgrade for the casters that I could get, because I think it's only about 5 science, and we could get it if we want to continue using them, but we're not really using them on our bigger craft. So I don't know if it's worth us actually continuing with that process. I don't know. So there we go. We're just going to turn this over to about 60, hold it there. The casters will die out, and hopefully they will depart a little better than last time. Yes, they do. Oh, they hit each other, but that's fine. Bits flying off. That's probably going to land... Yeah, probably going to land all over the space center, but that's fine. It's not amazingly important to us. I'm sure that the ground crew down there are really happy that we've just said that. Right, so we are going up now. This is the important bit. I need to keep an eye on what's actually happening here. You can see our path is okay at the moment. We really want to be looking at crossing over here. That's what we're going to be looking for. So yeah, there we go. We're going to do that. So it's like that, right? So now we're lined up nicely. So we want this to basically be under here. We're keeping an eye on that. We can pull this down a bit more. We're now over 1,000. And a lot of this is actually going to take part in this map screen, actually. Let's have a look. Oh, we've actually popped off the target. So we're going to set target as again. That's annoying. Right. There we go. Get that lined up. Okay, you can see we are actually improving our inclination and everything like that to match. That's good. Just about there, I think, is where we want to be. There we go. Right. So we want this to basically go a little bit past that, because we are aware of the fact that actually we're going to, first of all, I'm going to try and loft this as far up as possible, because I don't want to worry about my rise and fall too much. I want to be focused on where we actually are inclination wise. So there we go. We're going, you can see now, if we follow on our path, we will actually, if I do that, we will at some point very soon go back past our actual required inclination. So that's good. We know we've got a nice chunk of stuff going there. We're going to go to zero now. There we go. We can hold that at zero. And I think we're about ready to kick off. We've got about, what, a few minutes. We've got half a minute left. And you see there, we're now actually looking at this and going, okay, let's have a look. Let's line that up. Oh, we can do our staging, get that going. We can also get rid of our fairing. There we are. So we've now got the craft there. So we actually can see at the top here, relative inclination is coming down. I don't mind. At the moment, I'm not too worried about. So that's the point there. I want to bring that down. So I'm actually going to do this, which is crazy. I'm going to put in a 50 degree burner. So I'm actually going to turn the craft slightly, and that should bring this apoapsis. Yeah, you go. So you see the descending node is now moving down. I want the descending node to come down to about here, because I want to be finishing my sort of inclination change burn a little bit quicker, a little bit sooner in this. I don't want to be up at full orbital velocity when I'm doing it. So I need to sort of hurry that up a bit. You can see my apoapsis is actually beyond it now, which is fine. So there we go. We're going to force that through. You can see my inclination is dropping down. And then what I will actually do is we're basically doing a dog leg right now. And because I set off a little bit too early there. So we're going to just let this come down. The inclination is going down. And then we're going to drop it back to zero. There we go. And then we will actually start doing a relatively tight turn, I think. We'll go get this lined up. There we go. So we're gonna be basically just letting this engine run a bit. We've got, what, 3 minutes? So we can actually do a bit of physical time warp. Get a bit closer. There we go. And now we're actually going to fire it back. We're going to go minus 80. There we go. And this is going to turn this craft almost on its spot. It's going to really give us that inclination change that we really want. Before we get to the apoapsis up there, in fact, you know what? We could actually take this to minus 90. Would probably be best. There we go. Really force it. There we go. Like so. So we're now turning it now. You can see we're actually starting to increase our inclination again. And hopefully that's going to be at about that point there. How far away is that? That's what, 13 seconds. We might have done this a bit too much actually, but we'll have a look. We'll see what happens. We will see. It's going to be tight. Yeah, the relative inclination is dropping. We're going up. Good. Keep going. We've got a lot of time to kill, actually. We're not too worried about this. We are using a lot of delta V, but we've got a lot in reserve, so that's not a problem. We're going to pop this back to zero. There we go. This is now going to swing round, hopefully a bit quicker, because we're going to hit 90 very soon. Come on. Here we go. Oh, we're going to have to go the other way now and fight that 90, because we've now gone a bit past where we want to be. So let's set that as target again. There we go. We're going to basically pull this back a bit, and we're going to wobble. We're wobbling backwards and forwards. We're going to let this run. There we go. It's running back now, so we can start to bring this down and just close in on it. Go. Come on. You can see our time to apoapsis is getting a little bit close, but that's not a killer. We've still got quite a bit of time left. And there we go, zero that again. And we're just gonna try and just play it ever so gently, because we want to get on to 90. There we go. So there we are. That's not so bad. Go the other way, but bring it back. And I think we're going to be okay there. Right. We'll leave it there. I think, yeah, that's not too bad. Right. And now we're hitting our apoapsis. So we're going to get focused on this now. We're going to stick on this 90 degree orbit. And we're going to focus now on actually getting to orbit. That's the key. We've got 50 seconds left in this engine. That's not so bad. We could pop up a bit of prograde a little bit. This tank's acting a bit funny actually to look at. I've noticed this sometimes, they render a little bit strange. I'm not entirely sure why. We are a little bit beyond our apoapsis. Here we go. We've got the apoapsis back, so we can now zero this out. The only problem with this upper stage that I always forget about is just how slow it is to respond to anything that you do. It just takes a little while to do the responding. So yeah, we have to remember that. Right, and then we're going to wait for this to get to the 1,000 kilometer apoapsis, and then we'll kill it there. Right, we're going up and up and up, and now, there we go. And then we're going to decouple. RCS is on, arm that. Let's check that we can actually maneuver. Yeah, we can. We can turn that off. Right. Right, so we are now in orbit. Let's have a look at what we can do. Relative inclination, descending node is 0.1 degrees. Okay, that's not bad, is it? That is not bad at all. So what we're gonna do is, I could do this manually and put stuff in, but we'll just go, we'll use MechJet, but I very rarely use MechJet. In fact, it's here, isn't it? Align planes. Hit that button. There we go. Let's execute the next node. There we go. And that's going to be 11 meters per second because it's such a small inclination change. And once we're on there, then we're just basically going for a normal rendezvous. Now, we are underneath the orbit of this one, so our period of orbit is less, so we're going to catch up. We're very lucky, actually, about where this is actually coincided with. So we're actually right behind it. We may actually go past it, though, when we're doing this because, yeah, actually, we are very close to going past it, aren't we? So we have to be aware of that. It might only be a couple more flights around the planet before we're actually right on it. Go there, get rid of that. So this is going to speed up and do its little burn. And this should put our inclination and everything basically bang on the same. And then this here will show up as 000, hopefully. Very small little thrust there. So we're gonna have a look. So we're burning, there you go. There's our target. You see, we're actually burning slightly off to one side. We could do this at the pole. If you were out of sync completely, you can do the realignment at the pole and just rotate the orbit around the planet a little bit of drift. I believe it's the sort of thing that, the sort of precession, I think that Starlink sort of uses at times when it's on high inclination orbits. It does it near the top of its sort of rise. I'm not entirely sure, though. I have to check it. Right. So let's have a look. Tell you what, let's do... This is an interesting way of doing it. We just do a wow. That's how close is that? It's within kilometers. Okay. Let's do a little maneuver up here. Add maneuver. There we go. Right. How close are they? That's not bad at all. Right. What if we do just some small changes? Little, that's not right. 57, 25, 24, 5. Wow, this could be a lot easier than I expected, actually. Take it to meters. That's 600 meters. Does go back there. A little bit of that, no. A little bit of that, no. A little bit of that, no. A little bit of that. 80 meters, 63. There we go. Right. We're going to put us within 63 meters, that point there. Relative speed 71. Relative speed, that's not bad at all, actually. That's really good. So I'll tell you what, we're going to pull this down a bit and we're going to try and just refine it ever so much a bit more. Can I get any more refinement? 115, 24 meters, that's 17. 7 meters, 5 meters. 5 meters is very close to it. Let's go for seven. Let's go for seven. I don't want to hit it while we're doing this. Right. So we're going to fast forward to that point. We'll get a bit of drift on our numbers, no doubt. And then we'll just, we'll actually get the MechJeb to do this. I very rarely get MechJeb to do stuff, but let's get MechJeb to do this as we come in. Right, delete node, current, right. We're going to execute node. We've got those maneuvering little ports, our RCS, on the front and back of the craft, so it should balance out quite nicely. So there we go. We can see we're actually right underneath the target, so next time round is going to be beautiful. There's that 62-kilometer closest approach we did have, and now it's just a case of, you know, how close are we going to get? Is this going to... Yeah, so it's going to auto-time warp towards it, and it's going to do its little thrust. The good thing about this is we can use MechJeb because we don't have to worry about engine starting up and shutting down and stuff. We have multi-use engines, basically. We can use them over and over again. We can use RCS, things like that. There we go. Pull it in. Oh, superb. So we're within... Oh, that's not brilliant. Let's try and just bring it in with a bit of manual. 21 meters. There we go. And turn the RCS off at that point, because any RCS more now will just take us away. So there we go. You will notice this craft is, of course, based on our little our navigation satellite system. So it's in amongst here. You can see the back of the engine there, actually, through the fuel tank coming up. So that's nice. And we've got our little thing there. So we don't care about the sunlight right now, even though we are in the sun. That's a lovely little picture, actually. Just isn't that nice? Right. So now we've got about 56 minutes until we have to zero our speed. I don't know how long it's going to take us to zero out, though. So we're going to, let's see, that one's within, that's so close, it's actually unbelievable. We're going to warp to here. We're going to warp there. Right. We get a little bit of a jump there again. And then we're going to come back, and it says that we are within, really? Oh, I hate it when it does that. Right. So we are now actually not as close as we were. We're actually now 11 kilometers. We've got a little jump because we time warp too quickly. That's my fault, and the game's fault, shall we say. So we're going to go to there. We're going to zero out our time, and then we're going to have to do old school Kerbal approach, which I'm not a big fan of. So I'll go to target. Yeah, we want target. I want retrograde. Turn the RCS on. Now, the interesting one here is, I wonder if I can actually get a little bit of... Can I close it in a bit? Yeah, I can. We can actually use a bit of RCS right now to close that gap. And we've got... Because we don't have dedicated RCS as such, we can actually turn that off. Because we don't have dedicated RCS as such, we can actually just... we can just use our fuel as we see fit. We've got this aerosine as part of our RCS system. Almost did the double wording. So we're going to bring this down, hopefully, by doing this to within that sort of kilometer range we were looking for. And you can see we're just doing a little bit of thrusting this way and this way to get together. I've identified already that's the way I want to go. We could actually, you know, use the markers on that ball, but we're just playing it by ear a bit and go that way a bit and that way. Right, here we go. Come on. Oh, we're going up again. And now can I do a bit of... No, we want to go this way. We're going to be within 2 kilometers. All right. What about a little bit more of that? Bit of that. Bit more of that. Okay, we're just playing around now because I want to get close approach that's reasonably acceptable. Just pulling ourselves... There we go. A little bit more that way. No, this way. We're just trying to drift this craft as close as possible. There we go. Getting it into about 200. Can I get it a little closer? 100. 80, 70. That's fine. Right. Let's put us in... turn that off. Turn this on. Put us in retrograde for target. There we go. You can see just doing that is actually throwing us... We're actually heading even closer, which is quite interesting. So the target's going to come past us, is that right? The target's going to come past us. Interesting. How far away are you? Is that our target or is that something else? We are targeting... Yeah, we are targeting that. So it's behind us currently on our orbit. It's about 4 minutes away. Oh, there it is. That must be that. That must have been the remnants of our craft, actually, or some such thing. Or might even be one of the probes around this that we're actually picking up. So we've got about 70 meters per second to burn. I'm going to wait until we've got about a minute before I actually start thinking about even firing anything. All right. It is coming in at a bit of a chat. There we go. Right. So there it is. Let's see what happens when we activate a bit of the old thrust. How quick does that go down? Okay, yeah, we're going to need to do this. This is going to require a little bit of burn time. So there we go. Right. How long until that? Okay, time's going down. Not bad. You can see that our intercept. Oh, jumping around a bit. Where are we? Where are we? I've gone. Where's our target? It's up there. There you are. We got a little bit of a glitch there. So you can see that our close approach is changing just a little bit as we get slower. So what we might do is just... I might just kill it. No, I think we're going to keep going. We're going to keep burning at full power. And we might do is... Yeah, we're going to use a bit of the old RCS to re-bring it in. So we're coming nice and close. There we go. You can see our time two there is actually going down as well, which is really nice. We have to keep an eye on that because we're going to let ourselves just drift closer as we get closer. So we can kill this now. And then we can actually apply a bit more of our RCS just to bring us in a bit closer again. So now within 10, 11, 12 meters, something like that. And then it's just a case of waiting. I know we can probably kill this velocity in... Ooh, we're getting a lot of jumping. We can kill this velocity in probably 10 seconds. There we go. Right, so we're going to fire up our engines. And go for it. Oh, we are going past, but that's all right. We want it to be above it. And there. Right. Oh, we fired too much. Now we need to go back the other way. I could actually just have engaged the RCS there and fired it, but we'll do this anyway. Right. What I actually did was I hit the wrong button. There we go. We're going to drift like that. Right. So that's my target there. Right. Set as target. Control from here. Right. Now I'm going to put myself in a normal negative, I believe is what I'm going to do. Or we can actually put ourselves in target mode. Target negative. There you go. Is that right? Or relevant velocity negative, target positive. I don't get what we're doing. Now that's interesting. What's this do? Parallel minus. That's what I want. Oh, I knew there was something on there. Alternatively, you can actually just manually do this and so forth, but I'm not going to do that, obviously. Right. So we're going to fire that a bit. And then we're going to fire that a bit. And I want to go up, do I? Yeah, we want to go... We're going to go up a bit. There we go. Right. So this is going to be hopefully a docking if I can get this at all right. Right. And I will say now, the ability for MechJib Smart ASS to actually hold you parallels or something is really useful. If you don't want to use it, use the normal. Put your craft in the normal position and just use that. We're actually going to do this. I want to do that. We're getting a bit of stutter. Going to pull this like that, and what we're actually doing now is we're just trying to bring it in. You can see we're 2.9 meters away. I want to do it like that. It would actually be better if I did it like this because my keys are the other way around. Right, so I want to go that way, I want to go that way, and I want to go forward a bit. There we go. Okay, now we're coming in, and I think we might be off target, but we'll see. We will see what we're going to be doing. Are we going to be close? Could be very close, actually. There we go. Oish, docked. Docking target is out of electrical charge. Wow, that's amazing. Is it actually out of electrical charge already? Did it just eat it in one big go? Let's turn off the avionics. I think, where is the avionics on this one? Shut down avionics. There we go. Right. Let's have a look. Has that completed our task? We actually launched a new vessel. Dock to another spacecraft while in orbit. Launch a new vessel. We did actually launch a new vessel. I'm going to accept that. I'm actually going to go and accept that because you saw what we were doing there. We'd accepted that. We launched a new vessel. That is the new vessel. It has docked. It doesn't say multiple new vessels. It says new vessel. Right. I'm not accepting that. That's not acceptable. Comment below. Do you think I should allow myself that? I mean, I think that personally is acceptable. To give you an example, when the Agena failed to reach orbit, they changed the mission parameters. Didn't mean that they failed their mission to rendezvous and stuff. It just meant it was a different rendezvous. So, right, you know what? We're gonna actually. I wonder if can we actually transfer resources from here to here? Let's move charge in. That's a good idea. Right, and then if I decouple. Because what I was actually going to do is use this to deorbit this, but obviously that's not a problem. Right, shut down my avionics so I can get a bit of a bit of electricity built up. Right, so we're moving away. Okie doke. We're going to do that. We're going to activate this again. We're going to activate our avionics. We're going to set that as a target. We're going to do this again just to see if it actually does it. Right. Let's see if it'll allow me to dock again. Just ram into it. Oh, it's stuttering. There we go. Oh, big pull actually on that. Right. It has now done something. Is that the original contract? Yeah, so we've done the first docking. That's interesting. So we had to dock, undock, redock. That's very strange. I wonder whether because this didn't have an electrical charge, actually. So by bumping electrical charge into it, I wonder whether that's actually fixed us or whether it's now classing it as docking because I don't know what. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to deorbit this because we don't want it anymore. It's a bit of a mess for us. How are we going to do it? We're going to come to here. We're gonna, you know what? We could just turn this so that it is. Let's control from here. Control from here. That's the best way to do it. Let's put us on retrograde. Oh, we can't because I have to turn this on, don't I? Right. Okay, because this avionics is not big enough to control the whole craft. I forgot about that. Right. So now we're going to put ourselves on retrograde. There we are. Do we want to dump anything? We want to dump liquid oxygen. We want to dump electric charge. No, kerosene. Let's dump the kerosene. It's excess. Dump the HTP. And I think the NTO we need. Yeah, we need all that. Okay. And then we're just going to fire the engines up. Do we have the ability to fire an engine? Hello? Throng? There we go, we'll just do that. Right, is this going to have enough to deorbit us? I don't think it's going to, actually. I don't think it is going to, we'll have to see. So let's fast forward this a bit. Oh, it might actually, it might be able to. So I'm going to deorbit this. If you'd like a gratuitous re-entry shot or this thing coming through the atmosphere, give me a shout. I can put this on, but I don't think it's really required. Cleaning up the environment as we are now. So from me, until next time when we probably launch something a little bit bigger, have a great one.